Also ich krieg hier schon wieder einen zu viel.
Are you kidding me?
Jeder ein Hurensohn, der das gut findet. Ist mir scheißegal, ich beleidige auch noch deine Großmutter. Das ist not okay. React wird lustig, das Video wurde schon 20 Mal reupload und bisher immer gelöscht oder shadowbanned. Das ist alles deutlich schlimmer als merkwürdig. Das ist hochgradig besorgniserregend. Du, ich, dieses Video, das ist die richtige Entscheidung gewesen. Aber wenn du es geguckt hast, dann schau doch mal bei Meinungsmache vorbei. Da gibt es jeden Tag neue Informationen aus den Nachrichten und aller Welt mit politischen Themen. Oder vielleicht beim zweitklassigen Reaktionskanal. Denn wir haben so viele Reaktionen, dass die halt nicht auf den Hauptkanal passen. Also guck da gerne vorbei. Und jetzt weiter mit dem Video.
Cut!
I worked for Mr. Beast. He's a fraud. Ach du Scheiße. Was ist denn hier los? Mr. Beast haben wir erst gewhitenighted in Alman Arabica. Stellt sich jetzt der große Plot-Twist heraus und eigentlich ist Mr. Beast Satan?
Ist er Satan?
Wir werden es herausfinden.
The most valuable currency in the world?
Well, of course. If you could post something and everyone in the world would watch it, you'd be the most powerful man on earth.
We're not promoting gambling. I think people are going to see this name.
Oh, very smart with your money.
The guy who just throws away millions of dollars on YouTube videos is a gambler. Who would have thought?
Set up an illegal lottery for money.
It's gone to the point where he's gambling with people's lives.
You don't have to pay anything to enter the tournament.
How is this legal? I don't get it.
Hundreds of forged or fake signatures.
Ponzi schemes are great up until they just go bust.
Digga, was ist denn jetzt los, Alter?
Hi, I wanted to provide some context to this video. I'm a former MrBeast employee, and today I am alleging that the company rigged videos and did illegal lotteries and sold fake signatures. I would consider that fraud, okay? Thank you, enjoy the video.
So this is part one.
Okay, dude.
My investigation of Mr. Beast. I recorded this before the Chris stuff came
out.
Thank you
for done
I was also going to come out about the Chris stuff, probably in part two or three. Because I see a lot of people saying, like, oh, if you knew, why didn't you come forward? Why didn't you go to the authorities? Well, I was going to come forward. And also, like, going to the authorities isn't going to work because what are you going to say? Like, you heard rumors that this person is this way or that, you know, there's obviously evidence of, like, the Shad-based stuff. Like, that's been out for a while. People have internally known at the company that, like, Chris is kind of a potential minors attracted person, and the company protects her, and or they were protecting her, and they protected her as long as they could. Jimmy knew, everyone knew, so... You know, which I think that's more of a red flag than anything I'm...
What the fuck is happening gerade? Ich versuch gerade... Chris, was? We what the fuck?
I'm gonna reveal in this video, but, you know, these messages happen in, like, Mr. Beast discords, and... Yeah, I don't know. It's a mess when, like, Mr. Beast contestants are being exposed to, like, minor attracted persons in the company's protection.
Er meint Ava Tyson.
Them. You know, there's a big emphasis.
Who the fuck is Ava Tyson?
At the company of, like, how to manipulate children, like, understanding their psychology and everything, and, like, seeing that that's sort of used in weird ways. And, you know, there's been, like, parasocial relationships and, you know, encouraging, like, almost children simping for these people.
Nee, ich bin da, also ich versuche jetzt erstmal dieser Sache hier zu folgen und werde jetzt nicht in ein nächstes Rabbit Hole gehen. Da bin ich raus erstmal. Ich gucke jetzt erstmal, was hier los ist, weil das klingt schon wieder nach einem Rattenloch, Digga, da bin ich erstmal raus. Wir gucken jetzt erstmal dieses Video und versuchen, den Expose aus dem Maisfeld zu verstehen.
Und, you know, maybe that's as nefarious as it gets. Or maybe it goes deeper. Anyway, here's an old podcast clip of Jimmy explaining that he knows that his audience is young. Oh, which is an old clip. You could say, like, his audience grew up. I would say he's gained most of his audience since then, and his content's only gotten younger. Also, this clip really just shows that, like, he understands the YouTube analytics are bullshit, because he can try to use that as a defense, but he knows. So here's that clip, and then I'll get into the video.
The average demographic is what, 13 through 17? Is that the biggest spike in your analytics?
Well, I mean, mine's horse. It says, like, 18 to 24, but I know all my fucking viewers are little kids.
Yeah.
I feel like it's a lot like that because, you know, little kids lie about their age or they're on their, you know, like...
But, well, yeah, and then I have, like, a massive one for, like, the 40-year-old range because all the fucking idiots are on their parents' account.
Now, Mr. Beast intentionally manipulates these children's vulnerable minds for profit using three simple steps, which closely align with the three major types of behavioral learning. Step one...
Bruder, ich weiß gar nicht, wo meine Kamera hin soll. Ich packe sie jetzt nach unten links und hoffe, dass ich damit gut bin. Mehr jetzt sie ein bisschen kleiner machen, damit der Dings hier nicht komplett abgeschnitten ist. Und dann werde ich hoffen, dass ich hier an der richtigen Stelle bin.
is getting the viewer to associate the brand with trust and authority. Mr. Beast videos are real, and he's a great guy that gives away big...
Also, wer glaubt, dass Mr. Beast Videos real sind? Also, ich glaube, dass er Sachen weggibt, aber dass er halt geskriptete Konzepte baut. Gibt er denn die Sachen nicht weg?
Rewards to his loyal followers. I will show you irrefutable evidence in a minute that his videos are in fact fake. Step 2 is showing the viewers that when people interact with Mr. Beast in a way that benefits Mr. Beast, when they do what he tells them to do, they win big rewards.
Is he subscribed?
You are subscribed. Here's some money. Have a good day.
Some of them feel like I just walk around with $1,000. It's like, oh, thanks for watching my videos.
Hit that subscribe button because you might bump into me in real life and it might make you a lot of money.
When people...
Es ist halt hart manipulativ, ja.
People are devout followers of Mr. Beast, they get rewarded. And step 3 is finally calling on the viewer to act in some way that benefits the brand, promising big rewards in return. Now it's your turn to do what Mr. Beast tells you, and you will win big rewards. But you actually won't unless you're famous or friends or family of a Mr. Beast employee. So young, impressionable viewers are made to believe that Mr. Beast is a trusted authority who can give them big rewards. These young viewers are explicitly shown that dedicated followers...
Also, ich finde das, wir werden uns das jetzt hier reinziehen, aber ihr habt schon ein bisschen den Vibe von dem Doktor, der vor diesem, oder diesem Typen, der vor dem Whiteboard sitzt mit den ganzen roten Fäden. Same Vibe hier gerade, oder? So ein bisschen nicht so viel geschlafen, ein bisschen... overworked, ein bisschen zu viel Zusammenhänge gesehen, wo vielleicht keine Zusammenhänge sind.
Or is it random subscribers like themselves are winning big rewards when they do what Mr. Beast tells them? These young viewers are explicitly told repeatedly that if they subscribe, if they buy products or act in some way that benefits the brand, they will win big rewards. Trust Mr. Beast, watch him help others, contribute to his cause, and one day he'll help you too. That's the formula. Subscribe for a...
Also ich weiß jetzt nicht, ob Mr. Beast Jesus ist, aber ich verstehe den Zusammenhang.
Lamborghini and to make ride, you could be in one of these.
Subscribe right now. And you might get pictures next to the next video.
Subscribe and you might win a free car. Subscribe for a free car.
I love all of
you. Subscribe and you can come next time. I might give you $100. Subscribe again. Subscribe and you could win $10. Subscribe button. You could also win $100. Seriously, we always fly subscribers down. They never fly random subscribers down. Mr. Beast fakes his videos in ways that are worse than you realize. I say that because he's been exposed for faking videos before, and the common response is, why does it matter if the videos are fake? They're just meant to be entertainment. A large part of Mr. Beast's brand is the fact that he doesn't fake videos.
I remember when I first started seeing your videos, I was like, it's gotta be fake.
Oh yeah, like, it's a huge problem for us now. I actually have to dial back my content sometimes just so people think it's real. Also, if what we had to film was scripted, you know, because what we do is non-scripted, so you have to plan for a bunch of variables that you can't control, blah, blah. If what we did was scripted, holy shit, this stuff would be easy to pump out.
Have you ever faked a video?
No.
But this train track is CGI, these bus wheels are CGI, this explosion is fake, this shredder is CGI, this car is digitally lifted, this pit is fake, this guy is fake, this raccoon is a paid actor, sure, this island costs more than $1, this city is not abandoned, these buildings are CGI, but it's not your only way out, you can literally get an Uber to the airport for $20. That's not a lurker, it's just a guy. This whole room is fake, this contestant is an actor and a secret employee at Mr. Beast, they had him dive through this fake door.
Ja gut, das ist aber klar, dass das fake ist, also das ist jetzt wirklich fake alles, aber also... Okay, das ist fake. I know. Wenn ihr jetzt überrascht seid, holy shit, das ist ja fake. Okay, now you know.
Twice. This line is scripted. This action is scripted. In fact, pretty much all the videos with Mac are scripted.
You did it! Yeah! What we did was scripted. Holy shit. This stuff would be easy to pump out.
Let's talk about Mac for a second.
We will die. Do you understand that?
I found public records showing that Mac moved from California to Greenville, North Carolina, where Jimmy is located, back in August 2023, 2 months before he appeared as a contestant. According to a former Mr. Beast employee, this is around the time when Mac started working full-time on the editing team at Mr. Beast. Also, he didn't just move into any old house, he moved into a $1 million mansion. Now, I'm not gonna dox him, only some asshole would do something like that.
After doxing and bullying the pilot some more like a f***ing douchebag,
turns to Eric and says, how do I fly this thing? And Eric just starts pushing buttons.
But I did find pictures of this mansion online, so I fed them into ChatGPT and asked it to create similar images. And this is what it came up with. And it's honestly not that far off. His 6,000 square foot million dollar mansion comes with a movie theater and 7 bathrooms.
What are you gonna spend the $800,000 on?
I mean, my life's changed now.
Yeah, I'm sure that $800,000 is really gonna change your life.
Max, this is a nice car.
Tell me, where are we right now?
We're in the place that we drove to a few months ago.
Max, let's cut the shit here. What have you been doing for like the last year?
A lot of family stuff.
What kind of family stuff?
Just like, you know, playing catch with my dad, you know.
For a year? How do you make money? How are you, like, surviving?
Basically, my main strategy is I go to, like grocery store type places.
Grocery store type places?
Yeah, and I basically, what I'll do when I get there, I usually get, like an amount of food within, like, a week or so, right?
With what money?
Dieses Video ist sehr all over the place, aber ich versuche immer noch zu folgen. Also wir haben hier einen Gewinner eines Contests, des Videos, oder eines Mr. Beast Videos. Und dieser Gewinner dieses Mr. Beast Videos soll vorher schon in die Nähe von Mr. Beast gezogen sein, für ihn arbeiten und eigentlich nicht so ein unabhängiger Gewinner sein, weil die Gewinne gescriptet sind. Und er lebt in einem mehreren Millionen Dollar schweren Haus und das ist alles nicht so geil. Und das klingt auch nicht so geil. Das ist das, was ich jetzt verstehe.
The money that I made.
How did you make it?
Huh? Where? Listen, you're getting too caught up in the details.
They'll figure it out.
We will die. Do you understand that?
During this time lapse on the fourth day of 7 days stranded at sea, you can clearly see there's no one in the shelter. These are their empty beds. But after a hard cut, magically 5 people are awake, and 2 of the boys have bright yellow raincoats that they didn't have when it rained on day 2.
And after standing the whole night completely soaked...
You didn't spend the night soaked, Jimmy. You slept on the production yacht. It's ironic because this is one of the videos where they claim that they don't fake things.
But no, we have to be the real channel that doesn't fake things.
In this video, this wink was added in post. In fact, 58 was actually on the far opposite side of the room from 42, and he just didn't hear him. This whole revenge storyline was added in post. Multiple shots show how timers are edited in post. Timers are edited in post. Timers are edited in post. They also manipulated contestants' audio in post.
We got 15 minutes.
In general, if anything happens last second, it's fake. Or if you can hear someone's voice but can't see their mouth, the audio could easily be added in post.
Also... Ist Mr. Beast weniger ein unabhängiger YouTube-Content-Creator, sondern mehr ein klassisches TV-Produkt? Das ist halt, also das klingt einfach nach einem ganz normalen, das klingt so nach so einer TV-Show, ne?
Literally think I'm gonna kill you.
And yes, this lie detector.
Wie ein bisschen Trash-TV-mäßig, ne?
Your video was also fake.
Have you ever faked a video?
No.
It's still real to me, damn it!
Okay, so Mr. Beast fabricates some contestant dialogue and timers and movements and storylines and uses a bunch of shitty CGI, but who really cares? I mean, the videos are just for entertainment only, right?
Ja, also schon sehr viel fake. Ja, das stimmt.
I mean, it's not like he's ever rigged the results of a challenge. That would be impossible because he films with hundreds of random subscribers, right? Wrong. Let's look at this video. Not only were the results of this video completely scripted, but the contestants are not random subscribers.
So many people had jobs.
Oh, that contestant had to get out for her job? I guess you forgot she's your hiring manager.
Oh. Okay, jetzt wird's unangenehm. Oh, das ist lame. Das ist fucking lame. Weil jetzt ja hier auf die... Oh, Alter, die eigenen Mitarbeiter damit reinbringen, ist schon fucking what?
Oh, that contestant had to get out for her job? I guess you forgot she's your hiring manager.
Danke an Mickey.
That's fucking lame, bro.
I actually recognize a lot of people in this video, including Jimmy's own girlfriend. So yeah, the random subscribers you see in challenges are actually never random. They're almost always local to Mr. Beast, and oftentimes friends and family of Mr. Beast employees, or just the employees themselves.
Oh, fuck. Oh, das ist fucking what? Why? Das ist, also vor allen Dingen, das ist so einfach herauszufinden.
And when they do pull someone from outside of North Carolina, it's usually somebody who's in the industry, who's camera trained, who has built a following.
Hey, anyone I'm friends with watching that wants 10 grand?
They are never random subscribers. If you subscribe, you will not win $1 million. And what's even worse is that the results of this video were completely scripted. According to a former Mr. Beast employee, it would have...
Okay, in 100 boys versus girls, we were told it would be a PR problem if the boys won by a lot.
Ha 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 ha
Alter, wie eine, das ist ja wirklich wie ein TV-Sender. Das ist einfach, das ist. Also, we didn't have enough girls to film, so several Mr. Beast employees stepped in for the video, but most had to get out almost immediately, so the production was told to get more boys out to make it look closer. Also, at the end, when we divided the circle into 10 parts, there was a shift change for the people monitoring the contents. After that, I noticed no more girls got out, so I think the results were pretty much rigged.
Our problem if the boys had won by a lot, and because so many of the female...
Uff. Jetzt wird's langsam interessant. Jetzt bin ich so ein bisschen durch diesen chaotischen TikTok-Clip durch und jetzt wird's so langsam interessant. Mit dem Skripten habe ich kein Problem, nur dass Kinder manipuliert werden zu subben in der Hoffnung, ausgewählt zu werden oder Cash zu kriegen. Also tut mir leid, ich habe mit dem Skripten ein gigantisches Problem, weil es hier darum geht, dass Leute den Eindruck vermittelt wird, dass Leute Geld gewinnen. Also ich hätte mit Skripten auch kein Problem, wenn es darum geht, dass dein Lieblings-GTA-RP-Spieler mal wieder einen Endgegner braucht und dann spricht man sich so ein bisschen ab. Also let's go, ja, okay. Aber hier geht es ja offensichtlich darum, dass ein Contest von jemand random gewonnen wird und das gar nicht mehr so random ist. Da gewinnt halt einfach der eigene Mitarbeiter und das ist halt schon ein bisschen weit über klassisches ein Video ist geskriptet, sondern wenn man weiß, was Mr. Beast für Videos macht, dann ist das schon ein bisschen too much. Also mir geht es gar nicht darum, dass es klar ist, dass der ein bisschen zu viel CGI macht und so, das konnte jeder sehen in den Videos, aber dass dann die Gewinne an Leute ausgeschüttet werden, die aus seinem eigenen Team sind, das geht nicht, das sollte man nicht tun.
Contestants were Mr. Beast employees who got out immediately. Mm. Production stepped in to actually make the results of the challenge closer. You can actually see some of this happen on camera, like when Jimmy pays one of the boys $10,000 to leave, which is twice as much as the actual prize money, but doesn't make the same offer to the girls.
The boys were blowing you out of the water. I paid the one guy who knew how to solve them to leave. Now if you don't win, that was all for nothing.
At another point, he gives the girls a camera drone so they would have been able to see how many boys were left. It doesn't work out, but seeing how much they're willing to help them on camera, I'm willing to believe that they did, in fact, help them off camera. You know, apparently, at the end, they were only monitoring the boys to see if they stepped on the red line and not the girls so that the girls would win the challenge. And to be clear, obviously, the girls had an unfair start with having so many Mr. Beast employees get out immediately. You know, I think they all did deserve $5,000 for that, but also the boys should deserve a fair chance at winning, I think. I think that's the expectation when you run a game show. But hey, that was a while ago, so I'm just glad they're not doing another rigged boys versus girls video.
Oh, God.
So knowing that Mr. Beast likes the results to be close and that offstage producers can sort of influence how a challenge progresses, I want to show one more example. This is a real-time video, meaning that time elapses the same in the video as it does in real life. Now, immediately, the intro is sped up, and the timer is clearly added in post, and he clearly touches the laser here, but whatever, let's assume that it's all real-time. When he reaches the bottom floor, he has to turn these water valves. Now you can tell that these valves aren't actually connected to anything because the water flows out in an instant and it happens when he's not even touching the valve. The contestant also goes back to the first valve unaware that anything had happened and he's still able to spin it. So the valve seems to spin freely and isn't actually connected to the flow of water. So you could assume that producers might be off camera with remote switches to trigger the flow of water. And assuming they've tested this, the producers might know how long it takes for the water to clear out of the room, so they can sort of decide on the fly how many turns of the valve it takes, or just when to trigger the water in general to make the results close. And in this video, spoiler alert, the contestant wins the money, so rigging the challenge could be seen as a good thing. But there are many examples of contestants losing. And in traditional media, this kind of rigging is actually completely illegal.
We all-
Oh, wait, what?
Always have the same person tie all the knots so that we know they've tied them at the exact same tension. I mean, we get down to inches and then we have a standards and practices person. And if you don't know what that is, on any kind of a game show where there is a prize, yep.
Holy shit, ich hab gedacht, oh mein Gott, ich hab gedacht, das ist, das, ich wusste nicht, dass es das gibt. Ein Broadcast Standards and Practices?
To have somebody that ensures that it's fair.
Oh no. Das heißt, Mr. Beast ist da sogar schlechter als der private Fernsehkosmos? What the f?
They're out there essentially to make sure that we don't do something that would favor one player or one tribe.
Oh.
I paid the one guy who knew how to solve them to leave.
In my mind, I'm thinking it's a fair game, but it's not. If they were having problems finding people, they can see kind of what area you're in. And they came to my area many times, and I was in the smallest cupboard. They had like big ones, medium ones, and small ones. I contorted this little 4'10" body into the smallest space, and I was in there for hours. And they didn't even open the door because they were like, a person can't even fit in there. So they went in there, and they opened all the cabinets, and my heart was like, oh, they're going to find me. They're going to find me. And then I could hear them saying, like, she's not here. I don't know what you're talking about. Like, she's not here. The other thing that they said is, absolutely no climbing in the air vents or the ceiling. Mm-hmm. And they said it's because they do all their wiring in the ceiling.
So I am up here. Okay, I feel good about this spot.
If it was held accountable, especially because this was a YouTube original production, Zach would have been eliminated for cheating. He broke the rules. And guarantee you, if I claimed, if I climbed in the ceiling, Mr. Beast would eliminate me.
He was in the ceiling!
House View and Reads, what the f*** is this, Alter? Crater Games was not for charity. Whoa, 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 whoa. Crater Games 2 and 3, Trivia and Hide and Seek had nothing to do with charity. The winner of the competition would receive prize money under the vague condition that they give the money to their fans. Hey, my cousin is a fan of my video. Zach King made two highly viewed monetized videos with the prize money. Both the winner of the Crater Games 1 and 2... were accused of cheating. Mr. Beast does not care about his fairness in his competition. He cares only about making the best video possible. The trivia tournament also had multiple factual mistakes. No one seemed to notice. Spell possum, possum, oldest living animal question, correct answer, wrong. Ensuring fairness in challenges like this do not occur. But Mr. Beast thinks it makes the video. Okay. Alter. TikTok star Charlie D'Angelo family was accused of cheating on trivia questions after winning a 300,000 charity completion between influencers. Warte mal, der kann doch aber nicht einfach sagen, das ist für Charity und dann ist das nicht für Charity und die stecken sich das einfach ein. What the fuck?
Also, I think some of the MrBeast giveaways have been fake, but I'll get into that later. So now that I've explained some of the ways that MrBeast lies to build trust with his audience, I want to go on to explain how he exploits that trust for profit through running illegal lotteries, selling fake signatures, giving children diabetes, and more. A call to action is simply when you tell the viewer to do something, saying, subscribe is a call to action. Early in his career, Mr. Beast found a better version of this, where he
kauft geiles Essen von Löwenanteil. Holt euch ein Display. Kauft Rode. So, sowas zum Beispiel.
Takes a call to action and he adds positive or negative reinforcement to it. Now, as adults, we can recognize that subscribe for a cookie is a joke. It's not a real offer, but again, Mr. Beast's audience is primarily children who may have authorities in their life that actually use sweet treats or video game detentions as forms of reinforcement. And you aren't born understanding sarcasm. Whatever the reason, these reinforced call to actions are more effective than just saying subscribe. Oh, but there's an even much better version. The call to action giveaway.
If you guys want to win a brand new PS5, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel.
I can't believe people are still doing fucking giveaways. Holy shit, it's so annoying. Stop this fucking shit. I'm so tired of it. Fucking 10 years of YouTube, people are still like buying subs for this shit.
So over the next 7 days, I'm going to be giving 1,000 random people that subscribe a free Samsung Galaxy S24.
This is legal. I don't get it. All you have to do is subscribe to your channel.
All you have to do to enter to win one of these phones is subscribe.
It's a scam. Holy shit.
Doesn't look that good, Digga.
I literally spent over $1 million on these phones. And we
literally spent $1 million.
Julie found him 1 minute before Zach. I spent over $1 million on these phones. All you have to do to enter is hit that subscribe button.
Samsung, I just want you to love me.
So yeah, that's what a call to action giveaway is. At best, they are a way to buy subscribers, but...
Warum mache ich sowas nicht, Alter? Was kann ich denn machen? Abonniert mich für... Boah, Was gibt's denn, mich zu abonnieren einfach? Habe ich ja nichts. Also wer mich nicht auf Twitch abonniert mit mindestens Twitch Prime, der wird sich heute mindestens einmal den kleinen Zeh anstoßen und erhebliche Schmerzen haben. Das ist das Einzige, was ich euch anbieten kann. Also wer mich nicht mit Twitch Prime abonniert, wird heute im Laufe des Tages sich so unangenehm an dieser scharfkantigen Ecke des Bettes
FCK
den kleinen Zeh anstoßen und zusammenbrechen, während er schmerzens verkrümmt auf dem Boden liegt, wird er an diesen Kommentar Twitch denken Prime und sagen, oh mein Gott, warum habe ich nicht abonniert? Das ist mal ein Call to Action. Das ist mal ein Call to Action, oder? Unter Umständen wird der Schmerz so gravierend sein, dass eine Amputation nicht auszuschließen Twitch
Prime
ist.
Is not a crime.
Und das Relatable an dieser Sache ist, jeder hat es schon mal erlebt. Jeder hat schon mal diesen Moment gehabt, wo er und dann wirklich hat er gedacht, oh, ist er gebrochen? Ist er schon wieder gebrochen? Und dann bricht man so kurz zusammen, weil man den kleinen Zeh wirklich das wird passieren, wenn du mich nicht mit Twitch Prime abonnierst. Is not a crime.
Much of the time, they are legitimate scams. Either a YouTuber doesn't actually give away a prize, or in the case of these live streams, they are illegal lotteries where the only way to win a prize is by making a purchase. And obviously, I'm not a lawyer, so I'm just going to show you the law and then show you irrefutable evidence of what's being done, and you can make your own conclusions. The FTC defines a lottery as containing three elements: a valuable prize, random chance, and consideration, which can be time or effort, but in most cases is just payment. To successfully run a contest or a sweepstakes, you must eliminate one of these factors. A contest, for example, eliminates chance, and a sweepstakes eliminates consideration. In determining if any MrBeast giveaways have been illegal lotteries, we need to identify a prize, which is distributed through random chance and cannot be won without spending money. On August 2nd, 2020, MrBeast livestreamed him and his friends signing limited edition shirts celebrating 40 million subscribers. And here are just some of the clips from that stream.
For those of you who are just joining, if you buy one of our limited edition 40 mil special shirts, we're celebrating 40 million subscribers with a really big video, then we will sign that shirt and some of them will get random prizes like this. In 10 minutes, right, because we gotta give them time to do their cart, we'll give two orders $500 each.
Das ist halt wirklich,
minutes, someone's getting $3,000 in their room. In 5 minutes, we're gonna do the same thing again. We're gonna put $1,000 in a random order. 2 minutes, newest order gets $2,000. Good luck, everybody.
So this was a 6-hour live stream. They took it down off YouTube, but 5 hours of it are still up on their Facebook page. And during those 5 hours, I counted 46 illegal lotteries.
Oh my God.
These lotteries are also run poorly. Multiple times they would say something like, buy in the next 5 minutes for a chance to win. And then 7 minutes later go, actually, the newest order in 30 seconds is gonna win.
In 5 minutes, we're gonna do the same thing again. We're gonna put $1,000 in a random order. Hey, Daryl, don't we owe someone $1,000?
We do.
Yeah, so, all right, so the newest order in 30 seconds, we are gonna put $1,000 in your package.
Also, das ist halt, was zur f***ing Hölle ist das denn? Was ist das denn, Digga? Das hat so einen neuen Live-Charakter auch.
Steven Kane.
Okay.
Oh.
Steve.
And there is no second giveaway 30 seconds later, like Jimmy said. This is just one very shady giveaway. They just go on to talk about how Steven made a profit.
Steven's a handsome name.
So he actually walked away with some money.
We're proud of you, Steven.
I counted 13 of these extra shady lotteries where they did not give the prize in the original time frame that they said.
Okay.
Das ist nicht so geil.
So we're gonna put two iPhones in this pinata and we're gonna give it to someone who orders a shirt in 3 minutes. 5 minutes. Buy a limited edition shirt or hoodie.
Oh mein Gott, Alter. Bruder. Oh mein Gott, Bro.
And we're going to pick a random one in 10 minutes and give them $2,000.
Have we done iPhones yet?
Yep. Oh,
we did one.
Oh, wait. Hey, yeah. Daryl, first, actually, before we do that, we never picked a pinata.
So these clearly fit the definition of an illegal lottery. These clips are also not out of context. No one ever said no purchase necessary. There's nothing in the description or on the website. At one point, MrBeast
ja, sobald du da musst du vorsichtig sein einfach.
That they ran out of PlayStations and he says, are we trying to not sell merch?
Our city is sold out of PlayStations. We don't have any. We have to give away. Are we trying to not sell merch?
So he clearly knows that they're making more money by running these illegal lotteries. Another shady thing he did was constantly suggest that they're doing too many giveaways to make a profit.
My guy over there doing the numbers is like, stop, please. It's like, you do realize every time you give away an Xbox and $1,000, you don't make money. I'm like, oh, I know, we're not gonna make money. What are we doing, guys? We're gonna check after this stream and it's gonna be like
oh, no.
What a waste.
Yeah, I know. We're gonna break neutral.
When there is just no way they were ever even close to losing money on this stream.
I don't know who this is, but you just got a pair of AirPods. Oh my gosh, we're not making money. Guys, we need to stop giving everyone something.
We've just lost like seven.
Almost everything that someone's bought, we put something in their package. I'm not gonna make money.
In 5 hours, they gave away about $50,000 worth of stuff and sold over 50,000 t-shirts. Selling these t-shirts at $42 each, profit margin would be about $22.
Warte mal, nee, da bist, also ich kann dir eine Sache sagen, ne? Aber die Profit Margin, was kostet ein T-Shirt?
About $50,000 worth of stuff and sold over 50,000 t-shirts. Selling these t-shirts at $42 each, profit.
Wenn der die für $42 pro Stück verkauft, dann macht er nicht $20 Profit, sondern dann macht er, also das hängt jetzt wirklich davon ab, wo er die produziert, aber anlässlich dieses, da wird ein T-Shirt weniger, also das T-Shirt wird in der Größenordnung $5 im Einkauf kosten. Ich gehe jetzt nicht davon aus, dass Mr. Beast dafür bekannt ist, besonders großen Wert darauf zu legen, dass das Produktionen sind, die besonders auf die Qualität des Stoffes achten, wenn du verstehst, was ich meine. Also gehen wir mal davon aus, wenn der für $42 verkauft und der verkauft dir für 5, dann, Bruder, dann hat er halt $37 Gewinn. Sagen wir mal $30, dann ist das schon, also gut, Average Profit ist 25, man kann ihn vielleicht ein bisschen nach oben machen. Oh mein Gott, das ist schon ziemlich crazy. Okay, nee, doch, man kann das vielleicht so rechnen, dann hat man eine konservative Vorstellung.
The margin would be about $22. But even if they were making like,
ja, er hat recht, er
zeigt dir das. Each profit margin would be about $22.
$22 is a conservative estimate for just shirts, not hoodies. Also hier ist die, also das ist wirklich wenig, wie ich glaube, ne? Wenn du nicht Wert darauf legst, dass die Qualität besonders hervorgehoben wird und du nicht mit Zertifikaten arbeitest und sowas, dann ist das sehr, sehr konservativ gerechnet. Ich denke, es sind eher mehr.
$2, but even if they were making like $1 per shirt, they would still be fine. Also, by my estimates, only one in every 1,600 orders actually won a prize. And I guarantee he has real-time analytics on his laptop. He knows they make more money every time he says, oh my God, guys, we're giving away so much stuff. We're not even gonna make a profit. Please, don't you want me to make a profit? That's why he keeps saying it. Also, they just don't show how winners are picked. So it's probably not actually random. You know, humans have biases. Imagine Jimmy tells the guy off camera, hey, pick a name right now. And he sees two names. One is easy to pronounce, one is not. This is why lotteries are heavily regulated.
Ja, man muss da, ja. Ah, scheiße, Bruder. Das sind ziemlich viele rote Flaggen, Chat. Das sind ziemlich viele rote Flaggen, Alter. Das ist ein ganzes Footballfield mit roten Flaggen voll.
To ensure fairness. Also, obviously, you have to be 18 to play the lottery. It's gambling. Mr. Beast isn't just promoting gambling to children here. He's running the casino. And this isn't even close to the worst stream he's done. 4 months later, Mr. Beast signed shirts again, but this time it was a 24-hour live stream with way more illegal lotteries. And by the way, the rest of these streams were taken down shortly after upload, so all I have is some old clips and Reddit threads talking about them. Now, this stream did say...
Deswegen habe ich nie beim Sub-Refund gewonnen. Stay kann meinen Namen nicht aussprechen. Bruder, ich musste mir übel lange überlegen, ob ich dieses Sub-Refund mache, weil das bevorzugt ja eigentlich Abonnenten, die schon da sind. Darum habe ich mir einfallen lassen, wenn alle dabei sind, wäre es, glaube ich, okay. Deswegen kriegen ja Leute Subs geschenkt. Also das ist dann sozusagen meine Rechtfertigung. Aber ich denke, man könnte diesbezüglich auch sagen, jo, mal gucken. Am Ende des Tages muss man mit sowas einfach unheimlich vorsichtig sein. Also man muss wirklich vorsichtig sein.
We are doing a ton of giveaways.
Das hier ist schon ziemlich eindeutig nicht so, sagen wir mal, schlau. Das ist nicht schlau. Das klingt auch nicht besonders nachvollziehbar so. Ist nicht so okay.
No purchase necessary in the description. But to be eligible to win most prizes, you had to make a purchase.
Would you guys prefer, that we throw money in random orders or that we throw items in random orders?
Yeah. Somebody screamed in chat, I want a Switch.
Hey.
Buy a shirt.
In 30 minutes.
Ah!
We are giving away my car to someone that buys merch.
Which...
Ah!
Each giveaway is its own independent event. You can't give one prize to someone who buys something and a different prize to someone in chat. The prize where you have to buy something is...
Das ist nicht so geil, Digga.
Still an illegal lottery. Which obviously Mr. Beast knows this, but you know, he's a poker player. He likes a little bluffery. A little plausible deniability. You know, pretending to be ignorant of the law.
You know, YouTube's a little different than this.
Yeah.
Because YouTube, I can just do stuff like that. I can just be like, you know what? Pull up a database of 100 people that bought chocolate bars and pick 100 random ones.
Got it.
I think I can do that over here. I don't know. So I don't want to say anything. And then someone be like,
yeah,
actually, that's illegal.
Right.
I could not find any way to enter the big Tesla giveaway without spending at least $42.
We're giving away a Tesla to someone random who bought stuff.
They also gave away 24 tickets, which gave you the opportunity to be in a video. Again, most of these tickets, you had to make a purchase to win.
One random person that buys in what time frame? 10 minutes.
Oder es ist so offensichtlich, also es ist so offensichtlich nicht okay. Also jetzt kommen wir so langsam an den Punkt, wo die Frequenz von diesen Sachen so hoch ist, dass es offensichtlich nicht okay. Es ist es ist so, es müsste sich eigentlich auch langsam komisch anfühlen, das zu machen.
Put this in someone's order that buys something.
And we're gonna have 24 people, we're gonna put them in 24 different circles, $1 million on the line, have some fun, you know what I'm saying?
Also, this video never happened. There is no Mr. Beast video of 24 people in circles competing for $1 million. Unless it ended up being 100 people in a circle competing for $500,000, but that's a smaller prize and much worse odds. So like, did they just pocket the money or what? Hey, it's the pilot guy. Wait, he's about to be the first one out? That's unlike him.
Even though you got out first, I still have a prize for you. Just wait here.
Oh, first person out gets a car.
Und es ist wieder einer von seinen Leuten, ne? Es ist wieder einer von seinen Leuten, Bruder. That's not good. That's not fucking good, Alter. The designated winner. Ai, ai, ai.
Just happened to be your friend Mac. Another thing that just annoys me is Jimmy constantly says...
Das ist nicht so gut so.
...says during these live streams that he's just doing this for fun because he loves giving things away.
Oh, and I just like giving away stuff. It's kind of funny.
Imagine you just lost a bunch of money at the casino and the owner comes out and he says, Guys!
Ich bin heute reich geworden.
The reason I do all this... I just love giving away money. Also, you're 7 years old in that example.
Oh mein Gott, Alter. Ey, dass das halt so ganz klar an Kinder gerichtet ist, macht es so noch so viel weirder.
It's insane that he can flip these massively profitable illegal lotteries targeted towards children as an act of generosity.
I'm going to give you guys a few minutes to go place an order at shopmrbeast.com. Anyone watching any of the lives, and we're gonna throw iPhones in some of them.
And again,
what?
And there are very.
Das hört nicht auf. Das hört einfach nicht auf.
Videos of this live stream on the internet. I think Mr. Beast probably copyright strikes reuploads. But almost any clip you do find will have some new violation of internet gambling or sweepstakes laws.
I thought it was him. I was like, keep going.
Wait, really?
Let's go!
Wait, it's literally like his initial.
Who is it? My cousin.
Wait, really?
Actually, that's illegal.
Some of the common complaints we see in threads about this live stream are that they only signed large t-shirts, so when they selected an order to give a prize, it was apparently always a large or extra large t-shirt. They kept saying things like buy in the next 15 minutes for a chance to win and then not honoring it. Multiple people claiming that their name was read to win a prize and they never received it. This person is still tweeting about it to this day.
Oh no. Das ist schlecht.
There's a lot more people complaining about the deceptive
sales
tactics. Reading all this really upsets me because I spent money I honestly didn't have for 5 shirts at different times during the live when they said things like buy now and you will get prize or money. And I received 2 orders and nothing but shirt, both with MB and one with a heart and one with a smiley. I was hoping for at least a couple things for Christmas for my family.
Alter. Das ist ja noch richtig sad, Alter.
This commenter also goes on to explain that she's disabled, has PTSD.
Oh.
Lotteries and scams specifically target vulnerable populations like that. I'm disappointed. My son bought a signed shirt and was so excited. He watched a live stream and saw that people who bought would receive $100. He was excited to win something and be a part of his favorite streamer, Mr. Beast. When the shirt arrived, he was grinning from ear to ear. When he realized that there was no $100, he was visibly disappointed. He said nothing other than, I guess he meant everyone except me.
Oh my God.
He loves his shirt, but I'm really upset seeing him hurt. And obviously people can lie on the internet, but a lot of people are independently claiming the same things. Like that at the end of the live stream, they said they were putting $100 in every order. Now, my speculation is that they put $100 in every order that came across the table that they signed, but I'd be interested to see how they worded that. If the video of this live stream ever resurfaces, I think a lot of these claims will be proven true, which Mr. Beast definitely has this stream saved. He saves all his footage. So I'll ask you, Jimmy, will you publish this to prove your innocence? Also, using archive.org, we can see what the website looked like on the day of the stream, and while there's no mention of any sweepstakes whatsoever, it does say this limited tee signed by MrBeast and crew, but the description says it's signed by a member of the MrBeast crew, and it doesn't say anywhere that other members will sign MB, deceiving people into believing it was signed by MrBeast. So here's a clip of Tyler forging, or not, maybe not forging, using Mr. Beast's signature. So Tyler signs MB, which is Mr. Beast's signature. Then he covers it, signs his own initials, TC, smirks, looks around, and then quickly slides the shirt away. Could you make it any more obvious? You know.
Giga yikes. Giga yikes, Alter. Why the hell? Why though?
No, you don't accidentally have someone else's signature as muscle memory. And again, I'm not a lawyer. I think this is fraud. Maybe they could say it's the brand's signature. Even though it's clearly implied that this is Jimmy's signature, which was established during the last live stream.
Oh. Hey! MB, Mr. Beast. So this is Mr. Beast's signature?
No way, this one was signed by Mr. Beast. It's just got the MB.
Was it though? Was it though?
But that means it's signed by Mr. Beast.
Yeah, nee, ist es so? Ist das so? Yeah? Maybe not.
That's obviously his, Mr. Beast. This is so cool. That's obviously his. Mr. Beast.
You know, some people bought these shirts as collector's items or even investments, and this puts into question the authenticity of all Mr. Beast signed merch, which other.
Oh no.
Otherwise could have been very valuable one day.
Oh no.
This was clearly muscle memory, and judging by his body language, he knew he exposed this. Even Tariq notices Tyler slip up and immediately looks into the camera, looks guilty, and then readjusts his body and rubs his hands together. Also, Mr. Beast said during the live stream that this is the last time he'd ever sign anything, and that was just a lie. Illegal lotteries targeted towards children and selling fake signatures. I mean, imagine if any other YouTuber was caught doing this.
Oh, he's so true. Oh, he's so true. Das ist so wahr. Das ist halt jetzt, da muss man ein bisschen aufpassen tatsächlich. Das ist der Punkt. Oh Gott, Alter, stehen wir in einem neuen Arc? Ist Ende 2024 der Arc, wo Mr. Beast von YouTube gebannt wird und er einen Kick-Kontrakt und einen Kick-Vertrag unterschreibt? Oh mein Gott, das wäre verrückt.
You're very smart with your money.
The guy who just throws away millions of dollars on YouTube videos is a gambler. Who would have thought?
By this point, Mr. Beast noticed a problem with these CTA giveaways. I mean, obviously they're illegal, but more importantly, they're not as profitable as they could be. Look at it like this. There are two value propositions.
What? Sie sind nicht profitabel. Das klang, also ehrlich gesagt, klang das für mich schon ziemlich profitabel, ehrlich gesagt.
Oppositions at play here. The perceived value of the product and the perceived value of the chance to win a prize. So for something like these $42 t-shirts, if the viewer values the chance to be in a video at $10, they need to value the t-shirt at an additional $32 to make the purchase. So the more expensive the product, the less effective the lottery is. Yeah. You want to get the product as close to $0 as possible.
Also müssen günstigere T-Shirts hergestellt werden.
So people are just paying for the perceived value of the lottery. That's yeah. What's most profitable because humans can't accurately comprehend the difference between one in a million odds versus one in a billion odds. They both kind of just compute as I have a small chance to win, which Mr. Beast is well aware of this flaw in human mental arithmetic.
Yeah.
At past a certain point, the average human is like, large sum of money, click. And like, right. Larger sum of money doesn't really impact the viewing experience.
So also, the larger your audience is, the more profitable a lottery will be. Anyway, Mr. Beast wanted the cheapest product possible to use for these CTA giveaways. Basically a piece of paper, but you obviously couldn't sell a piece of paper without getting backlash.
Piece was to try to do a sticker sweepstake, but they quickly removed the promotion because it encourages mild vandalism and spreading garbage. Oh no.
So in January 2021, 3 months after the last shirt signing stream, Mr. Beast did a live stream where for only $10, viewers could send a picture to the moon. Wait, JPEGs that are going to the moon? And of course he
Yeah. Yeah, that's, yeah.
Did more illegal lotteries.
Just to keep things fun and interesting, as if putting a photo on the moon isn't interesting enough. Someone who puts a photo on the moon, or if you buy the bundle, whatever, in the next 30 minutes, we'll just fly you down to be in a video.
3 years later, the spaceship finally launched, carrying beautiful pictures of deceased loved ones to the moon, where they would be immortalized. It fucking exploded.
What the f***?
So obviously Mr. Beast refunded everyone, right?
No, he did not.
Right?
Oh no.
Is it Mr. Beast's fault that the rocket exploded? No. Is it his fault that he advertised it as for $10 I will put your photo on the moon?
For $10 I'll put whatever picture you want on the moon.
When he couldn't guarantee that? Yes, of course. October 16th, 2021, same.
Oder das hört ja nicht auf.
Thing. Buy this shirt to be in a video.
Why, bro? Why the fuck are you doing this?
Shopify dashboard. We just have like a random number generator, and then like we just put the number. Like if there's 1,000 orders, we just put it, picks a number between 1 and 1,000. Then my people.
Ich mag Moneten. Is that the Grundchat? Ich mag Moneten.
Give me the name. So, the first person that we're inviting to be in our Squid Game, if you want to enter, click the link in the description, buy the shirt or hoodie, is Alonzo.
The website did have a no purchase necessary link hidden at the bottom of the page, but there was no mention of this anywhere on the stream. Title was literally buy this shirt to be in a video. Mr. Beat said they were selecting random winners from the Shopify order list. All the clips I saw were the same thing. Buy in the next. Nein, Digga!
Diaz.
Bro, this is an actual $100 bill.
Oh, no. Wait, really?
Like, they actually sent a $100 bill.
Wait, what does it say? Oh, now we have to read the message. You and your crew are an inspiration to our young ones. He wanted to send you $100. Everyone click the link, or the view product thing in the bottom left. We're going to open three packages, and whatever's in those three packages, we're going to give someone random that buys.
Alter, kommt einfach, ist einfach, also... Ist Mr. Beast der größte spielsüchtige Unbekannte? Also, der muss ein gigantisches Gambling-Problem haben, Alter. Das ist doch eine Spielsucht. Hat Mr. Beast eventuell auch irgendeinen CSGO-Gambling-Partner, wo er dann auf der Webseite die Slotmaschine drückt oder so?
Mr. Beast is the American Dream.
Now I'm gonna get to what, in my opinion, is the most unethical CTA giveaway that Mr. Beast has done. But before I do that, I really want to drive home the point that the closer a sweepstakes is to an...
Oh mein Gott, mich erinnert das. Also, true. Ihr habt recht, ich hab Stumble Guys vergessen. Ich habe Stumbleguys vergessen. Diese kleinen Pendos, die mit diesem Jungen da diese Gambling-Scheiße gemacht haben. So vollkommen, ja, ist halt so. Also.
Illegal lottery, the more money it makes. Because, you know, every customer is supposed to be informed that they can enter easily for free and that making a purchase does not increase their chances of winning. Like, you're supposed to say no purchase necessary in all of your promotional material, which MrBeast does not do. This legal gray area only leads to people getting scammed, especially the elderly and children, who are also being introduced to gambling. The only people who benefit off of sweepstakes are influencers and scammers.
Warte, ich habe den ersten erkannt, den zweiten aber nicht.
The only people who benefit off of sweepstakes are influencers and scammers. Remember, Wiz.
ich habe den nicht erkannt, warte mal.
The only people who benefit off of sweepstakes are influencers.
Ah, Logan Paul ist das.
And scammers.
Mir fällt gerade auf, dass die Stumbleguys, oh mein Gott, ist das ein Plot-Twist. Ist das ein Plot-Twist, Chat? Ist das ein Plot-Twist gerade? Ja, lol. Für die Leute, die das gerade nicht raffen, ich habe ein YouTube-Video dazu hochgeladen, wie Stumbleguys eigentlich Glücksspiel für Kinder ist. Jetzt gucken wir ein MrBeast-Video von so einer Situation. Es stellt sich raus, MrBeast is ready to stumble in massive collaboration with Stumbleguys. Who would have thought?
Remember Wizza, a sweepstakes company that got exposed as a total scam and shut down? Even Omaze, the charity sweepstakes company, got exposed as a scam and had to shut down in the US? Or back in the day, there was Mystery Brand. You remember Mystery Brand?
So Mystery Brand is a website where you purchase different boxes.
Oh yeah, this is the, yeah. Ich kann mich erinnern.
Boxes with chances of winning things. Yeah. Take, for example, this women's Christmas box. It costs $15 to open, and you can win the most expensive Los Angeles realty. But you can't even click it, okay? It doesn't even give you more information, but apparently it's worth $250 million. Mm. I love that you can't click it. Like, they're just like, trust us. There's a $250 million house with your name on it. All the way down to Icicle, Site Balance. I'm willing to bet that this is probably what 99% of the people are getting.
Hey, at least MrBeast never wanted to work with this obvious scam. I mean, at least MrBeast's manager never went on some podcast and talked about how MrBeast really wanted to work with this company. No, what's this?
Is there anything you've had to say no to?
Tons. So a good example. So it was about 3 years or 2.5 years ago, and I started working with Jimmy. What was becoming really popular were these like mystery loot crate, like internet sites where it's basically like CSGO skins, but you'd go on and be like, here's the Supreme box, and you'd pay $50 for it. And remember,
Ricegum did quite a few people. Yeah. Yes.
Das ist übrigens einer dieser Finanz-YouTuber, irgendwann werde ich mal die Zeit haben und mir mal ein Video angucken zu der großen Finanz-YouTuber-Scam-Scheiße, die in den Staaten abgibt. Also, this is fucking crazy. Also, die Beteiligten jetzt hier, das ist alles ein großer Fiebertraum.
Yeah, they got a lot of hate for that. Right. Jimmy was, he wanted to work with that company when he heard about it, because there was a lot of money and we wanted to give that money away in a video. And I had to talk him back on it. I was like, listen, we're not promoting gambling. I think people are going to...
No, we're not.
See this negatively. So it's a long conversation that him and I had to have, which eventually we passed on the deal. And then Jake Paul and Ricegum ended up doing that deal and got a lot of hate for it.
Jimmy, why is your manager saying that you wanted to promote this obvious scam to your young impressionable audience?
Oh my God, Alter.
MrBeast launched Feastables, his new chocolate brand, back in January 2022.
I want to tell you guys about my new snack company, Feastables. They're made with only 5 ingredients, but still taste amazing. And I'm kicking off Feastables with something I've always wanted to do. 10 random bars are going to have a mystery ticket inside of them, and if you get this mystery ticket, we will fly you out to compete for a chocolate factory in one of our videos. And on top of that, Chandler, we're giving away over $1 million in other prizes to random people that buy the bars.
Dude, I need to buy these.
It's interesting to look...
Oh mein Gott, im Kontext all dieser Informationen ist das so fucking bad.
back at this, because a large part of Feastable's marketing campaign was the fact that it's a better for you brand, that it's healthier for you than Hershey's. Less sugar, only 4 ingredients, all organic.
I wanted to just make a better for you snack brand because I think a lot of the stuff out there is just terrible for you.
Because obviously so much obesity and disease comes from the stuff we eat. Like Hershey's, for example.
Bruder, du machst keine Schokoladenfirma auf, wenn du sagst, du verkaufst Schokolade, weil Leute zu viel Schokolade fressen und das ist schlecht für die. Deswegen machst du keine Schokoladenfirma auf, Bro. Bist du besoffen? Hast du irgendwann mal zu wenig Sauerstoff gekommen oder was? Du machst doch keine Schokoladenfirma auf, wenn du eine Fastfood-Kette aufgemacht hast, wo die Leute Hamburger fressen und sagst, das ist schlecht für die. Hä? Hast du Lack gesoffen oder was? Das ist doch mega dumm. Was? What the fuck? Bruder, nix an Schokolade ist healthy. Du isst entweder Schokolade oder isst keine Schokolade. Aber sich einzureden, dass Schokolade gesund sein kann oder weniger schlecht für dich. Come on, bro. Please don't do this. Please don't do this, man.
There's 10 ingredients, super processed. Our Fusel's bars are 5 ingredients and just all the ingredients are way higher quality. And it's infinitely better than the other options out there.
Das ist doch, da lügt man sich doch so in die Fresse, oder? Ey, come on. Wir müssen uns doch nicht vormachen, dass Süßigkeiten, zuckerhaltige Getränke und sowas irgendwie gut für dich sein kann, nur weil ein bisschen wieder Zucker drin ist. Das ist doch trotzdem Scheiße für dich. Das macht, einem das vorzumachen, ist nur eine Überzeugung. Ich krieg hier schon wieder einen zu viel. Das einem vorzumachen, ist einfach nur eine Ausrede, die man dann haben kann, trotzdem mit seinen Sachen weiterzumachen. Du musst es halt einfach, man muss das auch mal sagen, Mann.
I got all the Feastable chocolates. Let's try them and rank them 1 to 6.
I'm gonna be completely honest. Totally not biased because if it sells more, I make more money.
I'm gonna be honest. And I hope Jimmy is sitting next to me and not getting his feelings hurt.
Compare it to Hershey's. It's our crunch bar.
Okay. This is the one you believe in.
Yes.
Not crazy, Jimmy.
No?
No.
You don't like crunch bars?
I do like crunch bars, but again, it's too sweet.
Let me try this. Maybe these are defective.
Oh my god, this tastes good to me.
Oh.
Wait, we're supposed to be ranking them. I rated it the first one, so we're going completely off.
We're in too deep. I rate this a 10 out of 10. I give this an 11 out of 10. Keep in mind, only 5 ingredients.
Oh God, is that cringe? Is that maximal cringe?
Really healthier for you than the normal.
Oh my God. Is that krass? Oh no, the Dice of Cringe, Alter. Dice of Cringe Emote ist aber auch wirklich gerade hoch im Kurs. Da ist komplett der Cringe ist. Der Cringe ist hoch.
Okay, here's the thing.
Stell dir vor, der Geschäftsführer des Produkts, das du testest, sitzt neben dir und dann, oh no. Oh no, 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 no.
I didn't realize you were a dark chocolate guy.
Mm-hmm. I'm not a super dark chocolate guy. I do love dark chocolate. I get this a 7.8 out of 10.
Okay, so I'm starting to understand this, man. Okay. I'm starting to figure this man out. You're gonna like this one, right? You like salt? I love salt. I'm gonna get rid of these.
I love salt. You're
a dark chocolate kind of guy. Yes. Okay. I can read the room. The room is red.
I think it is a mask-off moment for Jimmy. Mr. Beast had already filmed content with the promoted Keith at this point. Jimmy was definitely expecting a favorable review of his chocolate in return. Jimmy is well aware of the law of reciprocity. He uses gift-giving as a business move. Here, though, Keith chose to maintain a level of integrity and give a more honest review than Jimmy wanted. Personally, I think Jimmy undervalues his own integrity, but it's especially important for a product review. MKG is a good example because consumers are trusting these people to give unbiased purchasing advice. Ja, aber Marcus Brownlee ist keine gute. Also, kurzer Einwurf. Hier beruft er sich darauf, ja, Marcus Brownlee ist ja ein gutes Example für consumer trusting in people to give unbiased purchasing advice. Marcus Brownlee ist keine unbiased purchase advice. Also der MKBHD ist so ein Appleboy. Also er hieß Appleboy. Komplett Appleboy. Wer da nochmal, kurzer Side Note, Louis Rossmann hat ich bin da so drin, Gott sei Dank. Louis Rossmann, der Apple Gigachat Zerstörer, hat ein Video zu gemacht zu dieser Propaganda von MKBHD und hat da mal Klartext gesprochen und das war schon sehr wichtig und richtig. Louis Rossmann ist da schon eine Instanz, der man glauben kann. Wenn ihr da in dieses Rebel Hole rein wollt, dann gebe ich euch ein paar Keynotes. Louis Rossman, Apple, MKBHD und Propaganda sind so ein paar Stichworte, die ich für euch habe. Und diese vier Stichworte könnt ihr nutzen, um die Videos dazu zu sehen.
Now in 2024, MrBeast changed the formula again to where it has mostly the same ingredients as Hershey's and even more sugar and more calories per bar. And this initial ad for Feastables where he calls it healthy is still getting millions of views a month. Also, I don't think you should ever advertise it as over $1 million in prizes when more than a third of those prizes are just coupons for more MrBeast products. Forcing you to spend more money if you actually want to redeem them. Ooh, a $5 coupon for Beast Burger. Now a single combo only costs $20.
Bob's Burgers Palace or f***ing Five Guys. If this can be successful, f***ing Five Guys.
It's so good.
Who cares? It's called Five Guys. What kind of f***ing name is that?
It doesn't matter. Burgers are good.
Branding matters.
Ist das nicht Cody Cole? Ja, das ist nicht so angenehm gerade. Bruder, das ist... Ich bin ein bisschen zu deep in diesen Rabbit Holes gerade drin, ne? Cody Cole, das ist schlecht. Gerade schlecht. Es ist gerade so ein Villain-Arc-Crossover hier gerade. Sehr viel passiert hier gerade. Wer ist das? Ja, also, wenn ich mache jetzt nicht die Can of Worms auf, aber wenn ihr euch diesbezüglich erklären wollt, Cody Cole ist auch ein großer Meinungsinfluencer oder Commentary-Influencer, der aktuell mit kontroversen Anschuldigungen zu tun hat, die ihn in Verbindung mit dem sexuellen, missbrauchlichen Intercourse mit einer minderjährigen, 17-Jährigen zusammenbringt. Tanner Mojo, als sie 17 war, hat er sie wohl. Und das ist problematisch. Wenn ihr diesbezüglich Informationen wollt, ich gebe euch einfach Input, ne? Gebe euch wieder Stichworte. Cody Co., also Cody und K.O., Tanner Mojo, und das reicht eigentlich schon. und dann findet ihr schon Videos, wenn ihr die wissen wollt. Dann geht's gerade, da geht's gerade ab.
Ooh, maybe you should have spent a little less time on this beautiful logo and more time on making the food actually edible.
Brother,
what's that?
What's that, brother?
Also, be for real, dude. Five Guys has a nice, clean, appealing aesthetic. You know, the name suggests humble beginning.
Warum finde ich das Video nicht, was der im Stream guckt? What? I worked for MrBeast, he's a fraud. I worked for MrBeast. What the f***? What the f***? Are you kidding me? Dieses Video ist hart geshadowbanned, Alter. Das ist kein Joke. Ich habe legit den Titel eingegeben und man findet dazu gar nichts. Oh mein Gott. Ich gebe euch ganz schnell mal den Link, ne? Nur für den Fall. Nur für den Fall. Hier ist der Link zu dem Video. Ich gebe euch mal den Link. Für den Fall, dass irgendwas mit diesem Video passiert. Das ist weird. Das ist fucking weird. This is not a good look. Das ist wirklich kein... Das ist merkwürdig.
This is like a-
ich bin ja mal gespannt, ob meine Reaction dann auch... Oh mein Gott, Alter. Jetzt kommt hier gleich der Aluhut.
Eight-year-old sloppy cotton candy piss burger. It literally looks like a piss burger.
Sit down.
Also, this digital wheel is not remotely representative of your actual odds. Mark Rober has talked about this common deceptive casino tactic before.
You recall from the carnival scam video, the most lucrative games for the carnival owner are those where people overestimate their chances of winning. That is exactly what happens in this game, thinking you were so close to getting a jackpot, when in reality, you weren't close at all. In gambling psychology, this is known as the near-miss effect, and people will spend much more money to try and win because they think they can-
Ah, schade, Digga. Schade, Digga, wäre fast drin gewesen, Digga.
And just do it on the next one.
So I am absolutely pigging out on Feastables.
Pause if you want to read. Problem gamblers have highest suicide rates in any addiction disorder study shows. There has been a recent rise in gambling products targeting children. Maybe video game loot boxes and unregulated online casino partnering with YouTubers and streamers are to blame. Either way, I find it concerning. At a time when the youth are living behind seven layers of irony and three enemy profile pictures, it's hard to know what's a joke and what's sincere. I've seen ironic gambling memes be used as a genuine justification for financial suicide. Make no mistake, if you gamble, you're a moron. If you promote gambling, you're kind of... Holy shit, Alter. It's not too late to escape from this idiocracy timeline.
And I'm trying to do this. Mr. Beast is teaching us gambling? Minus points because there's no cool music. Anyway, let's gamble.
Also, these tickets, one of them just so happened to go to a YouTuber with 700,000 subscribers at the time. Just pure chance.
This was just taped.
It was taped.
No freaking way.
So it is like really like total chance, obviously. Like you're one of like hundreds of thousands of names.
Talk to Jimmy Bell. What do you got to say to him?
Yeah, bull fucking shit, Alter. Bull fucking shit.
Jimmy, say thank you for picking us.
No.
Was hast du gerade gesagt?
Thousands of names.
Talk to Jimmy Bell. What do you got to say to him?
Jimmy, thank you for picking us.
No, he didn't. It was random.
I know.
Was it?
Thank you for picking us.
No, was it random? Also, this guy went on to win the chocolate factory, and extremely unlikely things do happen, but can we see how the winners were chosen, maybe? Because knowing how important it is to Jimmy that every video has entertaining contestants through the whole video, it's a little suspicious. I'll just say, in my opinion, as somebody who worked for Mr. Beast, I don't think this large YouTuber won a ticket purely by chance. So I know that producers are sort of able to pull strings behind the scenes to give some contestants better chances than others. And he runs these sweepstakes to like bribe children with gambling to consume more sugar. Like this is far fucking worse than a lottery ticket because a lottery ticket doesn't give you diabetes and only pay out your rich and famous friends. Like
das ist so weird. Thank you for picking us ist so fucking, das ist so merkwürdig. Das ist alles deutlich schlimmer als merkwürdig. Das ist hochgradig besorgniserregend.
Mr. Beast is bringing hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of new people to the candy aisle, whether he wants to admit it or not.
People are just walking to the chocolate aisle, and instead of buying Hershey's, buying Feastables. Like, people who never would have bought chocolate in Walmart are walking to the chocolate aisle specifically to buy Feastables.
You're creating a new market.
What?
Exactly. Yeah. I'm bringing new customers to the aisle.
Weil Amerika nicht noch fetter werden soll, ne? Alter, Scheiße, wirklich, ne? Also, wir können ja, also, meine Güte.
Okay, I guess he does want to admit it. You know, kind of a weird flex, not something I would brag about, Jimmy.
Make America fat again.
So maybe I should mention, technically, I'm a certified nutritionist, which really just means I paid $1,200 for a course and then failed to launch a health food company. But I know that poor diet and especially excessive sugar consumption is the number one cause of death and health problems in America, including some of the health problems that Mr. Beast claims to care so much about. Blindness, deafness, loss of limbs. Mr. Beast also just launched a combo with Zaxby's, which if you get a soda, it's over 2,000 calories for one meal.
Because obviously so much obesity and disease comes from the stuff we eat.
The only thing real in this video is the new Mr. Beast box at Zaxby's.
I'm pretty sure this...
Oh my God, Alter. Oh my God. Das ist das, was ich vorhin meinte. Du kannst diesen Take nicht machen, wenn du gleichzeitig noch so eine Fritteusenfirma hast, weißt du? Die wirklich, die, also das ist einfach, du kannst das nicht machen, Alter. You cannot do this. Stop talking about health, so das solltest du nicht tun.
This would be illegal in Europe. This is like more calories in one meal than the average 10-year-old is supposed to consume on a daily basis.
Yeah. Tell me how I'm killing little kids. Right.
New research finds childhood obesity rates are getting worse.
The number one killer in America is obesity. The number of deaths in overweight people surpass alcohol and smoking altogether.
For 30 days straight, we are going to be giving away $10,000 to a lucky customer who scans the QR code on the back of any new Feastable bar.
Das kann doch nicht normal sein. Wir haben letzte Woche legit über den f***ing, wir haben legit über Mr. Beast gesprochen, dass wir nicht verstehen können, also der macht ja eigentlich was Gutes. Und jetzt kommt dieses Video und es ist einfach alles, es ist, oh mein Gott, das ist nicht gut. Also es ist nicht gut, ganz und gar nicht gut. Warum? Karl und ich müssen mal aufhören, über sowas zu reden. Dann kommt nächstes Wochenende immer ein Exposed-Video.
It's just disappointing to see somebody pretend to care about the health epidemic in the US.
Dieselbe Reaction könntest du doch für Gönnergy, Red Bull etc. machen. Hä? Red Bull verschenkt Geld, wenn du eine Dose von denen kaufst? Also, tut das Red Bull? Kann ja, du, das ist ja der Take, den ich habe. Du sagst, dieselbe Reaction könntest du auch für Gönnergy und Red Bull machen. Und ich sage, bei Red Bull die verschenken Geld, wenn du das kaufst. Also, da ist ein Influencer, ich weiß nicht, ich kenne keine Red Bull-Influencer tatsächlich, der setzt sich vor eine Kamera und sagt, ich packe in dieses Red Bull mein Spuckig rein und wenn du dieses Red Bull kaufst, kannst du meine Spucke trinken. So, beispielsweise. Also gibt es denn Influencer, die das machen? Die setzen sich vor eine Kamera, das ist der Vergleich, den man machen muss. Die setzen sich vor eine Kamera, die nehmen einen Red Bull, die packen das ein und sagen dann, wenn du dieses Red Bull kaufst, du musst Red Bull kaufen, weil ich verpacke jetzt Geld in dieses Red Bull und dann mache ich das rein, zum Beispiel. Oder wenn du diesen Schokoriegel kaufst, weiß ich jetzt nicht von, die machen das. Hä? Wie machen die das? Müllermilch macht das. Okay, du vergleichst jetzt ein Gewinnspiel auf der Packung mit der Influencer-Kampagne, die wir hier sehen. Ist das korrekt? Weil wenn du das vergleichst, dann muss ich dir sagen, es ist nicht dasselbe. Und ich weiß auch nicht, warum es bei Gönnergy dasselbe ist. Weil bei Gönnergy kenne ich überhaupt keine Gewinnspiele. Kannst du mir gerne sagen, was bei Gönnergy der Gewinncode ist? Oder wie man das da was gewinnt? Gönnergy macht Gewinnspiele auf Instagram. Also es kann ja sein, ich weiß das nicht. Ich frage halt legit, ich weiß nicht, was die machen. Aber für mich wirkt das schon ziemlich extrem. Bei Gönnergy gibt es einen Code unter der Lasche für 10 mal 10.000 Euro. Mhm. Kannst sehen, aber wenn du einen Dosencode eingibst. Okay, das ist also tatsächlich schon eine sehr ähnliche Herangehensweise. Das ist fucking crazy. Aber das ist, ich glaube, hier muss man immer den parasozialen Faktor irgendwie noch mit dazusetzen. Also ich verstehe den Vergleich, aber für mich wirkt das hier nochmal besonders gravierend aufgrund der Frequenz und der besonderen Frequenz, ne? Diese Streams, dieses Kauf mein Scheiß und dann gewinnt eventuell der oder der, das ist schon ziemlich crazy.
Best only when it's profitable for them.
Ich verstehe den Vergleich aber, ne? Ich glaube, das ist halt alles Trash. So, ich weiß nicht. So, also, ja, ist Trash. Das ist Trash.
I know this point isn't going to resonate with a lot of people because of how normalized high-calorie and high-sugar diets are in America. But, like, bribing children to get into the habit of consuming excessive amounts of sugar, like, $10,000 a day as a giveaway is very deliberate because it's trying to create Repeat Customer.
Ja, man muss hier dazu sagen, das Mr. Beast-Ding ist halt besonders krass, wenn es um die ausgewählten Gewinner gibt. Das muss man sagen, ne? Also, das Glücksspiel so oder so halt absoluter Trash ist, das steht fest. Stimme ich vollkommen zu. Ich glaube, da kann man gar keine so großen Differenzen machen. Aber wenn dann Mitarbeiter und enge Freunde und Familie die ganzen Preise abziehen, so dann hat das nochmal so ein bisschen Geschmäckle, Digga.
That just buy out of habits. Like doing this, especially when you clearly understand how much of a health risk it is to these kids.
Because obviously, so much obesity and disease comes from the stuff we eat.
It's honestly just fucking evil to me. Yeah. And I pushed back against this a lot while I worked at the company. For Halloween this year, Feastables is planning on putting $1 million in a chocolate bar. And they wanted to do a bunch of like scummy marketing and shit. My manager literally said at one point that they wanted to associate buying a Feastables with your dream coming true. So they're pitching ideas like, you know, buy a Feastables, win 10K, buy a Feastables out of a vending machine, and the vending machine just starts spitting out money, buy a Feastables and it has a ticket to Disney World, whatever, right? And I don't want to put a lot of like hearsay into this video. You should just believe the receipts that I'm showing you and not what I'm saying. But I swear to God, I said to somebody at the company, I feel like Feastables is 70% a chocolate company and 30% a lottery targeting children.
Oh.
And this higher up person at Mr. Beast said it was probably closer to the other way around and was laughing about it. Like 70% a lottery, 30% a chocolate company. Everyone knows it's just the call to actions and call to action giveaways especially that drive sales. As soon as they stop, it's hard for large bargain retailers to sell this shit for 70% off. That's why they push them so hard. Once they stop the diabetes lottery, no one buys. Also, this is the website right now. Mr. Beast wants you to join the crew. Just so weird and scummy to me. I believe all the Feastables giveaways do have official rules and no purchase necessary clauses somewhere, but it's very difficult to find them. In traditional media, if you advertise a sweepstakes like in a commercial, you have to say in the promotional material itself, no purchase necessary. Somehow Mr. Beast gets away with not saying no purchase necessary in any of his promotional materials, not the videos, the descriptions, pinned comments, nothing.
To celebrate our launch of Milk Chocolate and Sea Salt, we went out, we bought 10 Teslas, loads of cash, and all these prizes you see on the screen. And prizes aside, unlike Hershey's, these bars only have 4 to 5 ingredients and just genuine.
Oh Gott, ist das cringe, Alter. Ist das cringe. Du hast legit dasselbe Produkt. Du hast es in den Unterschied. Also das ist ja schlimm, Alter. Also ich verstehe natürlich, dass das so aus einer Competition heraus passiert. Aber boy, oh boy, ist das kein. Das sieht nicht gut aus, Alter.
Definitely tastes good. Go to Feastables.com right now and order some chocolate. Only problem is the chocolate river is deteriorating. All the
The only place you'll find no purchase necessary is either on the Feastables Twitter account because it's a rule of the platform, and even still they try to push it. No perch neck or hidden deep in the Feastables website under a FAQ. And to enter for free, you have to mail in separate 3-inch by 5-inch hand-addressed written index cards. Up to 10 a day. Do you think kids are gonna do that shit or just beg their parents when they're at Walmart for the YouTuber diabetes lottery ticket? How is this legal? How do you-
Yeah, how the f*** is this legal, wirklich?
You mail something without making a purchase. Cards, envelopes, stamps. The free entry method can cost more than the chocolate bar itself. Also, going back to sweepstakes law for a second, payment isn't the only form of consideration. Consideration can also be time or effort that directly benefits Mr. Beast in some way. Like, I don't know, if he told his fans to clean up and organize his Feastables displays in Walmart for a chance to win $5,000.
Wait, what? I need your help next time you see Feastables in Walmart as soon to be new retailers. If you could clean up the presentation and make it look better, that'd make me very happy. I'm building a team to this routine need just to help this short term. Wait the f***. No f***. Way. No fucking way, Bro. Der hat nicht seine Zuschauer darum gebeten, seine Schokoladen in der Schokoladenabteilung im Konsum. Ist das sein verschissener Ernst? Hat er gerade gesagt? Das ist nicht sein Ernst. Hier schreibt jemand voll nett. Please, mach die Arbeit der Konsums oder was? Kriegen die dann wenigstens einen Obstkorb oder so?
Feastables displays in Walmart for a chance to win $5,000.
Was ist das Problem daran? Was ist das Problem daran? I need your help. Next time you see Feastables in Walmart, if you could clean up the presentation and make it look better, der sagt, seine Fans sollen kostenlos für ihn die Präsentationsreihe von seinen Schokoladenbars aufräumen, weil die ja so schlecht aussehen. Wie, was ist das Problem daran? Hier wird mit einer parasozialen Beziehung kostenlose Arbeitskraft akquiriert. Was ist das Problem daran? Wie, was ist das Problem daran? Das ist halt legit unbezahlte Arbeitskraft von potenziell fucking Kindern. Wie, was ist das Problem daran? Das ist gezielt an Kinder gerichtet. Are you fucking kidding me? What? Are you kidding me? Wie, was ist das Problem daran? Ich brauche deine Hilfe, bitte, wenn du das nächste Mal in den Walmart gehst und übrigens auch neue Märkte, könntest du dann bitte die Präsentation ein bisschen besser aussehen lassen? Das wird mich sehr glücklich machen, trauriges Emoji. Ich baue aktuell ein Team auf, die das routiniert machen sollen. Ich brauche jetzt aber deine Hilfe kurzfristig. What? Ey, jeder, der das okay findet, ihr seid Hu-Söhne. Hu-Söhne. Low joke. Alter, das ist nicht okay. Das ist fucking not okay. Die parasoziale Bindung aufgrund der Traurigkeit des Influencers auszunutzen, um kostenlose Arbeit zu machen? Are you kidding me? Jeder, der ein Hurensohn, der das gut findet. Ey, ist mir scheißegal, ich beleidige auch noch deine Großmutter. Bis hoch zu deinen Vorfahren, die sich irgendwann mal, also wirkt, das ist not okay. Das ist keine Debatte. Hurensohn. Das ist wirklich keine Debatte. Das ist ganz und gar nicht okay.
Dollars. Shelfie cleanup.
Imagine!
And $5,000 drawing? They thought this was going to be a monthly thing, but it got a lot of controversy, obviously.
Mr. Beast sparks backlash after asking fans to clean up shelves. Mr. Beast asked his fans to clean up the supermarket displays of his chocolate bars. What the f***? Das ist nicht okay!
How can I successfully clean up the shelves? Wow, glad you asked.
How can I success... What? No. No, no, no. Da gibt ne... fucking what?
No bars on the shelf? Go find an employee and ask them to check to see if there is product in the back room and ask them to bring them out so you can put it on the shelf to match the tags.
Der hat ne fucking Homepage Official Rules. Digga, ich hab wirklich eine Menge gesehen. Aber ich habe noch nie gesehen, dass Influencer die Arbeitskraft ihrer Zuschauergruppen in dieser Form kanalisieren wollen, um kostenlos ganz klar Aufgaben, die eine bezahlte Arbeitskraft erledigen sollte und nicht Kinder. Das habe ich legit noch. Davon habe ich noch nicht mal gehört. Ich wusste nicht, dass das existiert. Das klingt wie ein Konzept der Arbeitskraft, Wirtschaftsleistung, Erhöhung von Christian Lindner. So, wir müssen endlich mal ein bisschen wieder wirtschaftlich stärker werden. Das heißt, Kinderarbeit ist abgeschafft. Let's go. What the fuck?
What the fuck, dude?
Stellt euch vor, was für ein Schätzesturm, existieren würde, wenn jemand wie Monte sowas machen würde. Ja, moin, Digga. Ich bin's wieder, euer Gönnergy. Gönner, denn G steht für Gönn. Wenn du in Rewe gehst, Digga, ey, und du siehst deine, dass die ist unaufgeräumt und die ganzen Monster Energy stehen, es steht wirklich alles durcheinander, Digga, dann räum doch, ey, was los wäre, wenn der so einen Aufruf machen würde, dass seine fucking Zuschauer den Rewe aufstocken müssen, weil seine Dosen nicht what? Was los wäre? Bruder, da kommt der erste Allmann aus der Ecke und sagt, Arbeitssicherheit. Entschuldigen Sie, Arbeitssicherheit. Aber das ist doch Common Sense. This is not cool. Was?
Imagine a 7-year-old looking for the Walmart manager.
So, oh mein Gott.
So he can ask to stock shelves for a chance to be compensated.
What the fuck, Alter?
Dude, was Walmart in on this? This was not just one off-the-cuff tweet. This was like planned with instructions and graphics and everything. Also,
absolute Psychose.
A company asking children for selfies is a little bit weird. And while you're at it, if you want to maybe move some Hershey's bars and make sure that Feastables has plenty of space, I wouldn't complain. I just cannot believe they were going to give $5,000 to one of Mr. Beast's child laborers.
Und dann, cut, einer der Kinderarbeiter hat dann die Chance, $5,000 für diese Arbeit zu gewinnen. Einer von denen. What the fuck? Oh mein Gott. Das ist legit. Ich unheard of. Warum wissen wir das nicht? Jetzt mal for real. Warum wissen wir nicht, dass das passiert ist?
Stocking shelves.
Stell dir vor, du gehst zur Arbeit und dein Gehalt ist ein Giveaway unter allen Mitarbeitern deiner Firma.
No one at Mr. Beast was like, hey. This is a terrible idea. Actually, if you said that, you'd probably get fired.
This is the best tasting chocolate on earth. Good job, boys.
Whoa, 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 whoa. How do we know that's the best tasting chocolate in the world?
You're fired.
What? This is such horse shit. You can do that?
I mean, that is a bit of a stretch.
Yeah. The most shocking result was that Feastables never earned anything higher than a third place ranking.
But I do think their branding is like world's best chocolate bar is how do you get away with that? World's best chocolate.
World's best pizza.
What does that even mean?
Define that yourself.
Yeah, I mean, I guess.
Alter, ich schwöre euch, Ey, wenn ich das vorher gewusst hätte, dass Leute damit durchkommen, dann hätte ich nicht 5 Cutter eingestellt, damit die 7 YouTube-Kanäle und andere Kanäle überhaupt von mir verwalten, sondern ich hätte einfach monatlich eine Ausschreibung gemacht für die besten Videos und einer von den Leuten, die das Video schneidet, gewinnt das Gehalt. Das wäre viel besser. Weißt du, wie viel günstiger ich... Ich habe zwischen 20.000 und 30.000 Euro Personalkosten im Monat. Und weißt du, wie viel günstiger? Es könnten 5 oder 7 sein. Was zur Hölle? Why the hell? Wer gewinnt eventuell das Gehalt? Das ist ja großartig. Oh, ich komme nicht auf so gute Ideen.
I would think you'd have to... I don't know. I'm sure whoever worked on his marketing gave some thought to it or something.
Okay, one last point of consideration. Prolonged attention is definitely a form of consideration. In the attention economy, it is the valuable resource that advertisers directly pay MrBeast for. So in these live streams, when MrBeast says, hey guys, today we're doing a bunch of illegal lottery.
Alter, ich werde mir das so, also das wird wirklich in mein, das wird in meine consideration, also in meine Auswahlkriterien reingehen, wenn ich das nächste Mal nochmal einen Mitarbeiter einstelle. Ich sag's, wie es ist. Ich fass das nicht, dass das hier passiert. Ey, und dann in einem Video, das echt merkwürdig in den Algorithmus platziert ist, so dass man es zumindest nicht auf den ersten Blick erkennen kann. Es ist schon nicht so geil gerade alles. Es ist schon komisch.
But also, we're going to be giving away some free stuff to people who keep watching. He does that to boost viewer numbers.
I'm going to give you guys a reason to keep watching, okay? Here's what I'm going to do. Randomly, I'm not going to tell you when, it could be 10 minutes, 20 minutes, an hour. I'm going to randomly pick one person watching this IG live stream and one person watching this YouTube live stream. I'm going to give you each $5,000. So, Brilliant. Keep watching.
There's no predictable intervals for when MrBeast will give things away for free to people who watch. So you have to be present when they happen, which means viewers have to keep watching, which is time and effort that...
React wird lustig. Das Video wurde schon 20 Mal re-uploaded und bisher immer gelöscht oder shadowbanned. Ich habe das in meinen Reaktionsvorschlägen gehabt, tatsächlich. Jemand hat mir das gelinkt vor einiger Zeit und ich habe das jetzt gesehen und dachte mir heute Nacht irgendwann.
Directly benefits MrBeast. The more viewers, the more money MrBeast obviously makes, either directly through sales or AdSense or just getting boosted in the YouTube algorithm. So even the free giveaways could and should be against the law. MrBeast just uses gambling psychology to exploit young children for profit. He's just become the first casino where the currency you pay with is attention.
Do you think attention is the most valuable currency in the world?
Well, of course.
Or labor or money sometimes.
Oh, das ist wild.
Yeah, his core audience is like, I'd say like 10 to 12 year old boys. Older.
Oh mein Gott, Alter. His core audience. Vorhin hat so ein kleiner Bastardos, den ich erstmal rausklatschen musste, hat gesagt, das ist ein ganz schöner Stretch, dass du behauptest, dass nur junge Leute ihn gucken. Und jetzt, also ich... Oh mein Gott, Alter. Oh no.
Older people are a little bit over him. Some people kind of question the ethics, you know. They sometimes say in these videos where he like builds all these wells or, you know, cures people of all this blindness. It's almost like he's exploiting people for these views. So older audiences don't love him, but this tween audience, they love him. And they're thinking, you know, watching him could get me a car. So why wouldn't I?
Oh my God. Also, we want to read trading lottery tickets for engagement is not a generous or probably... Arcanesino is generous. Social media should not be paid to win. Teslas to my followers, like and comment on this post, tagging 2 friends to enter.
Give you guys a reason to keep watching.
Okay, now as far as fake giveaways go, I'm sort of limited in what I can say without exposing confidential information and getting sued. So my official statement is that sometimes things slip through the cracks, and personally, I believe that is intentional. Here's one example where someone on Reddit posted saying that they were promised free dog food for life in exchange for letting MrBeast use them in a video. 5 months later, they still haven't received their dog food.
Aww, Alter.
I actually sent this post to someone who works at MrBeast, and they said they were going to send it to the PR team, and then the Reddit post got taken down. So I don't know if it got resolved.
Oh.
Here's another example of things slipping through the cracks.
The second thing that I probably would do different is invest. And I know what y'all about to say.
Y'all about to go to the clip too, where Jimmy said that we set a certain amount aside to invest.
I know you talked about wanting to maybe invest 50K and then set aside like the other 23 for just other little nuances here and there.
This is not me calling anybody a liar or anything, because I know what y'all do. I know what the internet does. But what I think what happened was somebody that worked for Mr. Beast or something like that was supposed to probably help me invest, but that didn't happen. I talked to Jimmy after I won $1 million, after I finally like got the remaining amount in my bank account. I was telling him, I was like, man, I don't want to fail. I don't want to be like how everybody's saying, like I'm gonna run out of money and do all this crazy stuff. I was like, man, Jimmy, please help me. And he said he was gonna help me and we was gonna invest, but yeah, that didn't happen. So
if you actually watch this video, you know, Mr. Beast does say that they're not going to be irresponsible, that they're going to try to set Mark up for life, and that they are going to help him with investing.
What we're actually going to do is be responsible and try to set Mark up for his future. So we're going to make smart purchases like a house, cars, and do some investing.
But according to Mark, Mr. Beast only gave him an hour to plan what house to buy, and then gave him only 24 hours to spend the bulk of his money for a video.
Time. I wish I would have had more time.
Unter diesem Gesinn, in diesem, also das ist, also ich habe am Anfang von diesem Video, das jetzt wirklich schon fast eine Stunde läuft. Oh Mann.
And I wish I would have planned out stuff better. Like, that was the best example I can give you is when we had planned out the house and stuff. I literally had an hour. He had somebody come to my house. And we sat down and we planned all this in an hour. Yeah, they came to my house and we planned this out in about an hour. So I wish I would have had more time, and I wish I would have did a couple things differently on the time management side, which I guess I really couldn't help because I had to spend it. I had to spend the money and I had to like do all this. So
I'm starting to think he might have been a little bit better off if you didn't make him spend $1 million in 24 hours for content.
Can I just say, I'm super glad you won $1 million.
All I need from you is a signature right here. The vehicles are yours.
What we're actually gonna do is be responsible and try to set Mark up for his future.
You better not read it. You're a millionaire. You ain't got time to read.
The more you show us around, the more I'm like, thank God you won $1 million.
Yo, get a close-up on how poor he was before I saved him. No.
Like, shocked. Like, have your hands over your face. Like, you're as emotional as you can be. So, like, have your hand reaching for it and then, like, be, like, shocked. Like, you're... Yeah. Now act a little surprised. Like,
es kommt noch ein Video? Es kommt noch ein Video dazu? Wie zur Hölle soll das noch schlimmer werden? Also fassen wir das mal ganz kurz zusammen. Ich bin mit der Information oder zumindest mit dem Mindset hier reingegangen, dass Mr. Beast zumindest in seinen überschwänglich übertriebenen Videos einen positiven Impact hat. Wenn er Häuser baut oder wenn er Geld weggibt an Leute, die das vielleicht brauchen, weißt du? Aber es stellt sich raus, dass das im Rahmen von Bereicherung gemacht wird, das mir nicht klar war. Also das war mir nicht klar. Also ganz und gar nicht. Das war mir nicht klar, dass dieser philanthropische Ansatz, also dieses Verschenken, was ja durchaus stattfindet, aber unter Bedingungen stattfindet, die man nicht rechtfertigen kann. Und dass unter Umständen Mitarbeiter und enge Freunde die Gewinner sind und nicht Leute, die das irgendwie brauchen oder dafür vorgesehen waren. Es ist eine Katastrophe. Für mich, also das mit der Kinderarbeit, Alter. Alter, wenn ich es nicht gesehen hätte, hätte ich es nicht geglaubt. Wenn du mir das erzählt hättest, hätte ich es dir nicht geglaubt. Wenn du das irgendwo, ich hätte es nicht geglaubt. For real. Ich hätte es nicht geglaubt. Das ist fucking insane. Das sind solche Kleinigkeiten im Verhältnis zu dem, was er tatsächlich an Guten tut. Wie viel Kinderarbeit ist es denn, also ich frage einfach mal, wie viel Kinderarbeit und wie viel Glücksspielsucht ist denn zu rechtfertigen für das Gute, was er tut? Vielleicht kannst du mir das sagen, damit ich weiß, wann wir die Grenze erreicht haben. Weil ich das nicht weiß. Ich finde das grundsätzlich schlimm. Besonders in der Frequenz, in der wir das haben. Ich wusste davon nichts. Aber ich bin auch nicht verstrahlt genug, um jetzt mit Schild und Schwert Mr. Beast zu verteidigen. Weil, why the f*** should you do this? Warum sollte man das machen? Warum sollte man das tun? Ich glaube nicht, dass durch den Tweet und die Anleitung auf der Website so viel Kinderarbeit geschehen ist. Wie viel Kinderarbeit ist denn geschehen? Also du gehst davon aus, es ist Kinderarbeit geschehen, aber es ist nicht so viel Kinderarbeit geschehen, dass das irgendwie problematisch wäre. Hm, okay. Und es ist auch nicht so schlimm, dass er das im Zusammenhang mit einer kurzfristigen Lösung für seinen kommerziellen Erfolg gemacht hat. Ist auch nicht so wild, ehrlich gesagt. Weil es ist nur ein bisschen Kinderarbeit. Es ist nicht so viel Kinderarbeit. Es ist viel weniger Kinderarbeit, als man glaubt. Ey, Bro, come on. Will nur aussagen, dass ihr manche ein wenig überreagieren. Nein, 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 nein. Du hast dich schon aktiv dazu entschieden, Mr. Beast hier den deutlich favorisierten Punkt zu geben und zu sagen, Alter, der macht so viel gut. Das war schon ein ziemlich klarer Ich will wissen, warum du das tust. Weil du kennst ihn nicht, er hat nichts für dich getan. Du hast nur die Wahrnehmung durch die Videos, die zum großen Teil hier einen ziemlich negativen Eindruck haben. Und alles, was du dazu sehen kannst, ist das, was du dazu sehen sollst. Aber jetzt mal ganz ehrlich, warum zur Hölle? Warum würdest du das tun? Warum würdest du so weit gehen und für jemanden in diesem Zusammenhang, für den, der so viel Gutes tut, in deinen Augen, so weit gehen und das verargumentieren? Das verstehe ich nicht. Warum solltest du das machen? Warum? Natürlich Kinderarbeit gar nicht okay, aber Bruder, bist du dumm? Habe Mr. Beast immer noch als guten Menschen im Kopf durch seine Videos. Das kann doch jetzt nicht dein Ernst sein. Du wirst gerade offensichtlich von deiner eigenen Befangenheit hops genommen. Das ist doch nicht dein Ernst gerade. Du erkennst das sogar. Ich glaube dir anmaßen zu können, dass du das sogar raffst. Aber irgendwas in deinem Körper sagt dir, nee, nee. Aber du raffst ja da. Das ist ja Blödsinn. Du hast es ja gerade gerafft. Du sitzt ja gerade da und du raffst das ja. Du weißt, dass das schlecht ist. Aber warum wertest du das denn dann trotzdem noch so? Warum sagst du, ja, aber er hat ja ein Haus gebaut. Und da ist ja okay, wenn er ein bisschen Kinderarbeit benutzt. Er hat ja Geld verschenkt. Da ist es vielleicht nicht so wichtig, dass er das Geld an die eigenen Mitarbeiter und Familien und Freunden verschenkt hat. Verstehst? Das ist doch Schwachsinn. Mit so einer Aufarbeitung, what the fuck? Das ist doch Scheiße. Wir müssen doch grundsätzliche Standards haben diesbezüglich. Wenn wir nicht grundsätzliche Standards haben, dann sagen wir, ja gut, also bei Apple ist das nicht okay, dass die das machen. Aber Mr. Beast hat auch ein Haus gebaut. Hat Tim Apple schon mal ein Haus gebaut? Das können wir doch nicht machen. Hier ist schon wieder eine Relle. Aber er ist jetzt nicht das Ultimative. Bruder, warum zur Hölle? Leute, was ist das Problem? Warum kann man nicht einfach sagen, der ist scheiße, dass er das tut? Warum muss man denn sagen, aber es gibt Leute, die sind schlimmer? Bruder, was ist euer Problem? Wie wertet ihr das? Niemand sitzt hier und sagt, ja Gott sei Dank, Mr. Beast ist nicht ganz so schlimm wie Logan Paul. Wisst ihr noch, als der mit der Kamera auf eine tote Person in Japan gefilmt hat? Puh, also Logan Paul will ich nicht sein. Hä? Was ist in eurem Kopf falsch? Was ist falsch verdrahtet? Stop it! Don't do it! Keine Verteidigung für jemanden, der offensichtlich ein bisschen reingeschissen hat. Hä? Das macht doch keinen Sinn. Why the f*** should you do this? War das Video nicht lang genug? Haben wir nicht also, what the fuck? Ich meine, ich sollte nicht enttäuscht sein. Ich bin es aber manchmal, weil so viel Lack kann man halt nicht saufen, ja. Ich wollte den gar nicht verteidigen, ich wollte nur, halt dein Maul! Ich wollte das gar nicht, aber doch hast du, halt dein Maul jetzt, ist gut, schreib nichts mehr. Hör auf zu schreiben, einfach stop it, dann guckt da keiner mehr drauf. Aber manchmal wird mir halt klar, dieses Enttäuschungsding, ich meine, wenn wir uns angucken, wie die Scheiße mit Mois und seiner Tat, wie damit umgegangen wird im Internet, dann wundert mich eigentlich, sollte mich gar nichts mehr wundern. Ne? Jetzt werden wieder eine Leute sagen, oh, ist aber nicht so schlimm wie bei Heiler, haltet euer Maul jetzt. Ne? Das ist gut. Ich will jetzt auch gar nicht weiter, ich will nicht. Ich habe hier schon wieder ihr habt alle, jeder, der das sagt, ihr habt alle Lack gesoffen, hört auf Lack zu saufen. Und hört auf, und es ist gesund für euer Health, hört auf Schokolade zu essen, ist auch gesund für euer Health. Macht nicht einen Lack Light. Auch wenn ihr Lack Light trinkt, trinkt ihr immer noch Lack. Ist vielleicht ein bisschen gesünder, ist aber immer noch ungesund. You get what I mean? Und ich verpiss mich jetzt. Ich hab jetzt auch Wochenende, ne? Lack Zero ist immer noch Lack.
Kommst du in meinen Stream, dann geh ich ehrenlos auf Mutter. Danke Mickey an der Stelle, ich geh ehrenlos auf Mutter.